going to run through a new DIY kit that we have developed specifically for hydraulic cylinders or rams, and that's actually installing what we call a pilot operated check valve or a load hold valve. So the purpose of this is, with nothing connected to it and just this valve, even if you were to disconnect the hoses, this valve would actually be locked in position. It won't actually, this cylinder, sorry, will be locked in position. It won't move in either direction. It actually needs a signal into the opposite port to actually unlock it and let it move. So that's why they're called the pilot check valve. So the advantage of this kit is that we've sourced some fittings and adapters, so you can actually assemble this yourself onto your cylinder without using special flaring tools or welding or anything like that. So these are called a metric compression fitting. What you need to be very careful about is that you put the cutting ring on the correct way. This is the correct way. This is the incorrect way. So that's been put on the wrong way. And this is a recipe for leaks. It will damage the nut and it might seal temporarily, but the nut doesn't go on as far and the seal isn't as strong. So it'll cause you some dramas. So this is really important that orientation of this cutting ring is around the right way. So the important thing though is the length, all right? And you need to be able to cut the right tube lengths. So what we're going to do is leave these fittings loose. And the first thing we're going to do is actually measure from the end of the thread to the end of the thread quite accurately. So to do that quite accurately, I'll actually measure from the 100 millimeter mark. And that's measuring 750 millimeters, but we're at the 100 millimeter mark, so 750. Actually no, it's measuring 749. 749 minus 100 is 649. So that's the first part of the length. So we've got 649, which is from the thread to the thread. But if you were going to cut that tube 649, it's going to be too short. Actually, it needs to measure down into the fittings on both sides because they're a slightly different depth of fitting. And the best and most accurate way to do that is with a depth gauge with a set of verniers. Now, the best way to do that, if you look down there, you can actually see the bottom of the seat where the taper ends, and then there's like a little shoulder, internal shoulder. So we're just going to measure in there. And that's 7.3 millimeters approximately. And it should be something similar on the other side.
A little bit different on the side.
That's 7.7. millimeters, so we'll add that together. So we've got 649 plus 7.3 plus 7.7. So we need a total length of 664 millimeters. So these are designed for a metric tube. These are just more readily available in Australia, that's why we use metric tubes. You do it up as tight as you can, finger tight, and then to actually stop it leaking, you actually lock this nut up, which actually squeezes an O-ring into a taper. But for the purposes of this exercise, you need to leave that loose, because the only way to get a 664mm long tube into these tubes is to actually angle these fittings like this. So we're going to have to make, kind of just gently flex the tube, push it into there, and then push these back into alignment. All right, so let's measure that tube and cut it. Measure twice, cut once. 664. Carpenters say it, hydraulics people say it, fitters say it, mechanics say it. Let's get that a bit closer to the work. Special hydraulics tube. It's made from a, it's called a cold drawn seamless. It's actually extruded under high pressure. So unlike some pipes or tubes, you can get this in different wall thicknesses, but there is no seam. It hasn't been welded together. It's actually been extruded like a piece of pasta, but under high pressure. Get rid of the internal burrs. Blast it clean with some. The external part of the tube where the cutting rings are going to fit has to be unmarked. There can't be any burrs or vise marks or dags or deep scratches. It has to be quite clean and smooth. If it isn't, you could try polishing them out with some emery paper. So we're looking for 664. We've got 663. Should be still okay. Always check if it fits. Again, make sure taper pointing towards the end, the narrower part pointing towards the end of the tube. Okay, and that's going to go that way. So that's going to go into there. Somehow we've got to try and get that into there. And as usual, anything with hydraulics, cleanliness is important, right? These valves will not hold if there's any contamination, any slight burr, any metal filings. So you need to work as cleanly as possible. Yep. So let's put that in there. Let's put that in there. Okay. no movement there. That's nice and firm. There is no slop. Okay. I'm going to put this in the vise because this is driving me insane. First thing to do is to line up along the cylinder, make sure everything is nice and straight. Hold this 90 degree fittings. See how it moves? You've got to actually lock this nut up here. And as you do this nut up, it forces an O-ring into a C, so that'll prevent that from leaking. And we'll do the same with this end. See, again, the same thing, it'll wobble. So try and get it straight. Pull it up. It's always better to use the correct size spanners. But we're DIY, so we make with what we got. Okay, so everything's still tight, and then the formula is 5 flats from where it goes finger tight. So 1 flat, 2 flats, 3 flats, 4 flats, flats. Do the same on the other end. Now what I'm going to do is actually pull this back off so you can actually see what doing this up has actually done to the cutting ring. What it's actually done is actually crushed this onto the tube. It does rotate, but it rotates because it's not under any compression, but it won't actually move up and down the tube anymore because there's a tiny little raised edge on the inside of both of these, and these have now bitten in and actually created a groove all the way around both on this face and on the back face. So you've got two sealing faces, and then that taper, sealing on the taper, and then back taper as well, keeping everything together. The other thing I need to quickly just mention is that you know you've done a great job when this cutting ring, there is a small gap of between 2 to 3 millimeters between the end of the cutting ring and the end of the tube. If you've done that, you've done a great job. If there's no gap, or the cutting ring is beyond the end of the tube is too short and you've done something wrong and you must start again. All right, so as long as you've got a little bit of tube overhanging the end of the cutting ring, you're good to go. If there's no tube over the end of the cutting ring, you've done something wrong, you must start again with a longer piece of tube. So, so important. Obviously, once it's already been done up, you don't need to go 5 more flats again because you've already done the compression work. All you need to do now is just do it up. So that's how you put a pilot check valve, load hold check valve onto a hydraulic cylinder. Basic tools, no flaring, no welding, a little bit of thread sealant, 2 O-rings, 2 adapters, 1 valve, 2 cutting rings, two nuts, a small piece of tube. That's it, guys. Hopefully you learned something. Hopefully this was of benefit and you learned a couple of tricks. If you like, subscribe, give us a thumbs up, and we'll catch you on the next project. Some interesting stuff coming very, very soon. Bye for now.